Surprise!
Not for you.
Keep going, Peppa. Surprise!
Oh, please. Save your drama, queen.
No wonder we can get a hold
of you. Good timing, Danielle.
This is only about the fourth or fifth time that I speak in front of a group. Usually, before I speak in front of a group, my beautiful sister writes some stuff for me to orate. So I'm going to try to do the best I can. First of all, we're all here to honor my sister. Let's all give her a hand. We can't forget my brother-in-law, Bill. Let's give Bill a hand. If it wasn't for my brother Bill and my sister, I doubt whether I'd be here right now. They're my survey parents. So I'm going to try to add them a little bit. It's hard to beat that video. As you guys know, I lived with my sister and brother-in-law for a while.
I thought he was my brother.
Yeah.
I had it, but I lost it.
Anyway, I lived with them for a few years. The best years of my life, seriously. I don't know how my sister did it. My brother-in-law was a very hard worker, but it was such a big family that it seemed like Monday through Thursday, we had beans and tortillas and rice. Friday was a treat. My sister would make burritos out of corned beef and potatoes. We look forward to that. So, sister, I love you. And thank you, everybody, for showing.
Pina, my cousin, is an inspiration for families, mothers, children, educators, and older people. Since I was young, I would hear my mother talk about my cousin Pina, who lived in Los Angeles. She would tell us about how Pina would take care of her family, and that she was an inspiration for all mothers, their children, and married couples. Years passed, and her children grew, and I realized that my cousin Pina was going to be the university and inspiration for older women. More 3 years passed, and I realized that my cousin Pina was established in a book, or published in a book, an inspiration for us all who wish to be successful. We have been corresponding for many years, first by letters. I have many of them saved, and all of them emailed. She always talks about her family and pride, for her family is the best thing in her life. Pina, you are happy and honorable. You live a passionate life, and you are understanding with all human beings. Congratulations on your birthday, and I hope that we continue writing for many more years. Happy birthday, and I hope God grants you many more. Love and admiration.
My name is James Hoover. I am Irene's son, and I'm going to read the letter that was written by both Alan and Art on behalf of my grandmother, when she was nominated for Mother of the Year in 1994. Our mother, Josephine Mattel Garcia, is a role model for all. She believes in family, hard work, strong morals, values, and education. Married at 15 to a man, 11 years her senior, they had 7 children. It had long been the goal of hers to get an education. She went back to earn her high school diploma from the same school and at the same time as her oldest daughter, Sally. When times were tough, she worked at 2 jobs, bringing the money, and attending classes at East LA College majoring in office administration. She loves to write poetry about her family and her heritage. She was born in East LA. She loves to write poems about her family, her culture. She's been a bilingual teacher assistant, office clerk, and secretary to the director of bilingual education. She graduated with an AA cum laude and was awarded 2 scholarships, then enrolled in Cal State University, Los Angeles, majoring in liberal studies, where she still attends classes. A member of Golden Key National Honor Society, she won 2nd runner-up for short stories she submitted. She contributes to the community by donating to scholarships for minorities and to Self-Help Graphics, a community art center in East LA. Her history-based poems add to knowledge about the past in a positive way. In 1996, some of her poems were published in the magazine from Cyclos. She writes to elected officials and has had letters published in the LA Times, most recently on June 14th of 1998. Wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, Josephine Mattel Garcia will celebrate 54 years of marriage this September, now 64. Throughout many years, attending night classes and working outside the home, her interest remains her family. Her great pride in Latino heritage is reflected in her poems and raising her family with good values. Traditional and modern, she encourages her family to be responsible and law-abiding. To improve ourselves and reflect in a positive way, our family and our culture to the wider community. Thank you for considering our mother for this honor, Hallie Botello Scales and Arthur Botello Garcia.
My mother is one of the family and a very ethical person. My mom's a very complex person in how she loves, in how she perceives the world, and how she looks at relationships. And growing up, we often played with ants because my mother is very ethical. And sometimes I didn't want to be very ethical. And I was very venturesome about getting in fights. Yes, keep going.
Can you sound up like I got a pair of, you know what?
No, those days are gone. But, so I would get in the fight at school. I come home and my mother would give me this lecture about that would take the higher ethical path. And essentially she would say, you know, you love God. You pray for the people that injure you. When you're young, that doesn't set in, but you know, later on, as I came back from the war and tried to regain who I was previously and grow, my mother was one of my role models, and my grandmother, who you saw in the video, my mother has this strength, and it's the type of strength that is there every day. And I wanted to be like my mother, have that strength to every day be able to get through school and to deal with the complexities that I found in the world, because I'm very much like my mother in that way. I love my mother. in a complex way, because that's the way we are, Bubba.
Very different.
Very different, yeah. But I'd just like to say on behalf of my my family and my wife, it's to be reached at this point, I'm reflecting back, we've had a lot of good years. We've been blessed with many moments. Not only that my mom's still here, but my dad. It's really good to see my cousin Bobby and relatives from Gresham. And my cousin Daniel and Danny and everybody else that was here on behalf of my mother. I just thank everybody for attending. It's my mother always taught me to be solid, to be hospitable to people. I'm just doing it on behalf of her city of hospitality. Thank you all for coming here today. Just to say happy birthday to a very wonderful person. Someone I'm proud to call my mother, Josephine Wodeo Garcia.
And I thought something was funny because she's very calm and relaxed for the most part. And I came to visit her one day for lunch, and I parked out on the street. And I was in the house, right? And I'm inside the house, and all of a sudden, oh, did you park in the street? And I was like, yeah. So they drove me out of the house, and it was a Friday, and the street sweeper was coming, and the cops, they give you a ticket if you're parked out there. So I go to move my car, and as I walk across the street, the cop comes right behind my car, you know, lights. And he's about to give me a ticket, and I real quiet went over and I talked him out of giving me a ticket. Grandma didn't know that. So as he leaves, she thinks, but he gave me a paper so the neighbors would think I got a ticket, and they still wouldn't park there. And so Grandma sees the paper, and she comes yelling at him. She's pretty much, kill the cop, basically, for giving me a ticket, and I come to visit her. But I didn't show up, and so it was kind of a very, nice to hear fight for me.
When I was living with my brother Ron, my sister, it was summertime, so I asked my brother Ron to get a job at the farm that he worked in. And he got me a job there. Right? I think I was making $1.19 an hour. My first check was like $37, right? So there was a Japanese market that my brother-in-law used to go to cash his check. So I cashed my check there, right? And I told Phil, I would like to do something, you know, just to show my appreciation. What are you talking about? I said, well, I want to buy some stuff for the house. He said, well, do what you want. So I bought a big piece of round steak and a watermelon. And I don't know if you remember that, sister, but that's what we had for dinner that night. And then I was like 14 or 15, and there was a couple of good-looking girls about my age walking down this aisle, and Phil gets a roll of toilet paper, and he waits till the girls are right in my face, and he says, hey, Pito, is this the kind of toilet paper you want? Crawling underneath the whatever, but that was Phil.
I'm guilty.
I'll never forget that.
A story about my mom, because this is just like a little anecdote type of thing. When she broke her shoulder when we were in Auckland, and I had to take her to the hospital, and we were in COVID, waiting for her to see the doctor and x-rays and all this kind of stuff. So she's in a wheelchair, and I'm sitting next to her, and I'm looking down, all contemplating and stuff. And I said, Mom, can you buy the shoes? Did you buy two pairs, but a different color shoes? Yeah. How do you know? I go, so you have one blue and one black shoe. And then I had to take her to Vegas, and they took her into the we're in the back, and you know, Melissa's shoulder was shattered and all that stuff. And before that, when we were there waiting, and the doctor said to me, and he was just